Thank you for joining me in the History of Science collections of the University of Oklahoma Libraries. Let's look at a story from the vault that throws light on the origin of mathematical astronomy in ancient Mesopotamia. This object looks and feels like any block of old red sandstone one might find in the hillsides of Oklahoma. It's actually the oldest object in the History of Science collections. Not nearly as old as a sandstone rock, not nearly as old as a dinosaur bone in the Sam Noble Natural History Museum, but we can date it to more than 3,000 years ago, to 1300 BCE. This is a cuneiform brick. Cuneiform means wedge-like in Latin. Scribes marked these wedge-like signs by pressing with a reed. The ancient Mesopotamian tradition of mathematical astronomy is recorded in cuneiform script like this. For the origin of this particular brick, we need to look in the westernmost region of Iran, directly north of the Persian Gulf. This brick comes from modern-day Chagas Anvil, not far from where Awaz and Shushtar appear on this mid-20th century globe. The Temple Tower, or Ziggurat, of Chagas Anvil is now a World Heritage Site. It is the best preserved ziggurat of antiquity. From the ziggurats of ancient Mesopotamia, scribes like the one who recorded this dedication created the science of mathematical astronomy, predicting the positions of the planets centuries into the future. The ziggurat at Chagas Anvil was faced with baked bricks, some inscribed with dedicatory inscriptions written in ancient Elamite like this one. This script is a dedication from the Elamite king beginning, "I, Untashnapirisha, son of Habanumena." Without the Babylonian contributions, later Greek astronomy, such as we find in Hipparchus and Ptolemy, would have been inconceivable. The Mesopotamian astronomers were the original source of quantitative methods in ancient mathematical astronomy. Mesopotamian astronomy was transmitted to Greek, Roman, Sanskrit, Chinese, and Islamic cultures in different ways and to varying degrees. In early Greek science, there was nothing comparable to the Mesopotamian achievement in astronomy until cultural interchange between Mesopotamia and Greece increased after Alexander the Great. By the time of this tablet, the Mesopotamian scribes had developed a system of mathematics based on place value, far more powerful than the numerical systems of the Egyptians and later Romans. By the time of this tablet, they were familiar with the square root of 2 and with what we call the Pythagorean Theorem. Given the lengths of two sides of a right triangle, the scribes could generate the length of the missing side at will. Equipped with a sophisticated mathematics, the scribes were prepared to develop an equally sophisticated quantitative astronomy. During the time of this tablet, the scribes collected countless observations of the moon and planets, searching them for omens that might correlate with agricultural prices, civic health, and affairs of state. Eventually, the scribes designated the 12 signs of the zodiac, perfected the lunisolar calendar, accurately determined planetary periods, predicted lunar and solar eclipses, and calculated important events in planetary cycles, including retrograde motion. Wherever else one encounters mathematical astronomy in the ancient world, one can detect the influence of scribes who worked in ziggurats like the one at Chagas Anvil and who wrote in cuneiform script on bricks like this one. Science is a story. What stories do you want to hear and tell about ancient Mesopotamian astronomy?